welcome back Sunday. I know you've all been busy all summer long.
Yep.
I know you've been involved in all kinds of activities, dance and ball and singing and different kinds of camps. And it's so great that you've had a wonderful summer. Did you have a wonderful summer?
Yes.
Yeah. How about the adults? Did the adults have a wonderful summer? It's probably our best summer on record, weather-wise. And so glad to be able to get out and to enjoy the blessings that God gives us every day. And that's we're truly blessed here in Newfoundland, for sure. So welcome back as we all come here and gather together in worship and in praise. And we're having a parish barbecue afterwards. We're all welcome to stay for that. Today I welcome Sarah Souvey. Sarah, can you wave your hand? This is Sarah. She's from the Zero Waste Action Team. She's going to be doing a presentation for us partway through in place of my sermon this morning. So Sheila, talk to us how we can help with environmental care, creation care, which is what we're called to do as Christians, as followers of Jesus Christ. We are called to care for everything that God has made, and that includes the environment. So this morning we're going to begin with our opening hymn and a refuge. Our new man is going to lead us in singing, but I ask you all to stand up and sing along. We're going to sing out the Lord has broken, and the words are going to be on our screen.
Sunrise.
hidden mountains and valleys, grasslands and forests, glaciers and avalanche, mist and snow.
Give to our God your thanks and praise.
Greetings to you, maple and pine, mosses and ferns, alder, lupin, dandelion, and lily.
Give to our God your thanks and praise.
Greetings to you, whale and shark, codfish and crab, seal, seaweed, mussel, and lobster.
Give to our God your thanks and praise.
Greetings to you, rabbits and cattle, moths and dogs, robins and seagulls, eagles, cats, bears, horses and moose, mosquito and bees.
Give to our God your thanks and praise.
Greetings to you, women and men, elders and children, pipers and teachers and cleaners and clerks, learners, job seekers, doctors and nurses, students and retirees, all who care, who love and who pray, who laugh and learn, who rest and play.
Give to our God your thanks and praise.
The heavens declare the glory of God, and the skies proclaim the work of God's hands. Day after day they pour forth speech, and night after night they reveal knowledge.
This is the creation of our God. This is God's
word. They have no speech. They have no words, no sound is heard from them. Yet their voices go out into all the earth, and their words to the ends of the world.
This is the creation of God. This is God's word and scripture.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The statutes of the Lord are trustworthy, making wise and simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, giving joy to the heart.
This is the creation of God. This is God's word and scripture.
The commands of the Lord are radiant, giving light to the eyes. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The decrees of the Lord are firm, and all of them are righteous.
This is the creation of God. This is God's word and scripture.
Please be seated for proclamation.
First reading is a reading from the book of Jeremiah. My joy is gone, grief is upon me. My heart is sick. Hark, the cry of my poor people from far and wide in the land. Is the Lord not in Zion? Is her king not in her? Why have they provoked me to anger with their images, with their foreign idols? The harvest is past, the summer is ended, and we are not saved. For the hurt of my poor people, I am hurt. I mourn, and dismay has taken hold of me. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then has the health of my poor people not been restored? Oh, that my head were a spring of water, and my eyes a fountain of tears, so that I might weep day and night for the slain of my poor people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 79, and the refrain for the psalm is, help us, O God, our Savior, for the glory of your name. O God, the heathen has come into your inheritance. They have profaned your holy temple. They have made Jerusalem a heap of rubble. They have given the bodies of your servants as food for the birds of the air and the flesh of your faithful ones to the beasts of the field. They had shed their blood like water on every side of Jerusalem, and there was no one to bury them.
Help us, O God, our Savior, for the glory of your name.
We have become a reproach to our neighbors, an object of scorn and derision to those around us. How long will you be angry, O Lord? Will your fury
A reading from the first letter of Paul to Timothy. First of all, then, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high positions, so that we may lead a quiet and peaceful life in all godliness and dignity. This is right and acceptable in the sight of God, our Savior, who desires everyone to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, there is also one mediator between God and humankind, Jesus Christ, himself human, who gave himself a ransom for all this was attested at the right time. For this I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I am telling the truth, I am not lying, a teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth, the word of the Lord.
Thank you. have decided what to do. So that when I am dismissed by the manager, people may welcome me into their homes. So summoning his master's debtors one by one, he asked the first, "How much do you owe my master?" And he answered, 100 jugs of olive oil. And he said to him, "Take your bill, sit down quickly, and make it 50. Then he asked another, "And how much do you owe?" And he said, 100 containers of wheat. And he said to him, "Take your bill and make it 80. And his master commended Dishonest manager, because he had acted shrewdly. For the children of this age are more shrewd in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light. And I tell you, make friends for yourself by means of dishonest wealth, so that when it is gone, they may welcome you into the eternal homes. Whoever is faithful in a very little is faithful also in much. And whoever is dishonest in a very little is dishonest also in much. And if then you have been faithful with the dishonest wealth that has been entrusted to you, who will entrust you with true riches? And if you have not been faithful with what belongs to another, who will give you what is your own? No slave can serve two masters, for the slave will either hate one and love the other, or be devoted to one and to despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I ask you all to please be seated, and welcome to our presence today, Sarah Sobey. Sarah is with the Zero Waste Action Team, and she's going to let us know about what they're doing in care or environment.
So we've been involved in what's called a brand audit in the past 3 years, organized by a global organization called Break Free from Plastic. And the goal of this organization is to shift the conversation from blaming consumers for pollution to blaming the producer. Right, we all know that the campaigns over the past couple of decades for plastic pollution have all been along the lines of "don't litter," "You bought it, so it's your responsibility to recycle." But that's never going to be the actual solution, because there's only so much that you can do as individuals. The true source of the pollution is the people who are making the plastic. So what this project, global project, is trying to do is shift the conversation. And what we wanted to do is also be a part of that locally in this province. So the past few years, we've been collecting plastics in households, volunteers who collect the plastics for 1 week or 2 weeks, and then we analyze them. So we look at what kinds of plastics are in households, and they all have a little number with the chasing arrows. So we look at the types of plastics, we look at whether it's recyclable or not in this province, and we also look at the brands. And that is one of the ways this project essentially punches up and aims to identify the actual polluters. So we can shift the blame and say, you are the ones who are making the pollution in this province. So we're trying to better understand where plastic comes from. Because plastic is a global problem right now. It is clogging waterways. There is plastic in everyone's body. No human has no plastic inside of them. And plastic also produces what are called persistent organic pollutants, POPs. And these are persistent. They do not break down. And they are severely polluting environments like the Arctic, where these pollutants concentrate and poison food, which is incredibly dangerous, especially to the Inuit populations who live in the north, and also anybody who lives on the south. Just because of the way the world is connected, everything is connected. Whatever we do affects everyone. plastic is a problem. And unfortunately, the way that corporations work is they will always try to shift blame. Right now, one of those proposed solutions is burning plastic incineration. And it's often called advanced recycling, chemical recycling. So that it sounds nice. The problem with chemical recycling, as it's misnamed, is that, well, there are many problems. So one of the problems is that it actually costs more energy to burn the plastic than the heat produces. And the second problem is that it's incredibly toxic. No matter how much of the toxins that you capture, some are going to escape, and then you're left with this toxic sludge. That what's going to happen to that? It goes into the earth anyway. So no matter what, we're still polluting. And the other thing with incineration is that it depends on plastic to operate. And so this doesn't actually decrease the amount of plastic that we're going to have in the world. It incentivizes to produce more, to keep feeding these incinerators. So what we want to do as part of our project right now is that we want to identify some things that we can do in the province to help reduce plastic pollution. One of the most effective tools to do this is called extended producer responsibility. So this is a piece of legislation that puts the onus, responsibility, on producers to take care of the waste that comes from everything that they create. So instead of the taxpayer paying for garbage, landfills, recycling facilities, all of this stuff, it shifts at least the financial responsibility, which is partial PBR, or the entire responsibility for management of the end of life of a product, so that it doesn't become the responsibility of the consumer once it's bought. They are responsible for it from start to finish. And this creates, ideally, incentives for producers to make the packaging more recyclable or less packaging because it can cost them less in the end to deal with it. So, in good news, this province has decided to develop EPR legislation. We're the last province in Canada to do it, but it's really exciting that the government has decided this is something we're going to pursue. So, our job, we think, is to try to make legislation as strong as it can be. Because as we can understand from any kind of legislation, it can be drawn up very strongly, very good, or it can be quite weak. And industry is very good, very persistent at trying to weaken any kind of legislation that they feel is threatening to their bottom line, to their profits. And this kind of legislation might have that threat attached to it. It seems like the tide is changing, corporations are more getting on board, but still, we have to be very careful that legislation is drawn up in such a way that there are as little loopholes as possible. And that's where our project comes in. So we have used our data and some research to identify the biggest polluters in the province based on the household waste that we've collected. And as far as we have seen, the biggest polluters are the grocery store chains, which is unsurprising. The biggest source of waste in this province is food packaging. Everything now seems to come in plastic. It's very, very difficult to avoid. And there isn't really much choice otherwise. There's not much we can do about it. So it's incredibly unfair to place the blame on consumers to deal with the waste when they don't really have another choice. So we want to hold these producers accountable. And recently, I think it was 2 years ago, potentially it was the original proposal, a company tried to open an incinerator, to propose to build and open an incinerator near Lewisport. Now thankfully, with a lot of mobilization and quick action on behalf of the population, I think we convinced the minister, maybe I'll say that myself. But the proposal was turned down, thankfully. But there is no legislation in the province to ban incinerating. So outside of all of the general toxic issues that is caused by plastic burning, we also don't want to bring this to our province. It would be incredibly polluting and I read the proposal, and this is very common for any kind of corporate proposal, right? They dilute all the effects. They're like, well, we're only responsible for looking at this like 1 kilometer squared, and if we look at the effects of 1 kilometer squared, there's not really an effect of pollution. Like, yeah, but the atmosphere doesn't work that way, right? Pollution will float away, and it'll affect everything, even if it's not that 1 kilometer squared that you're only responsible for. So we want to have legislation in this province to ban incineration. And as a team, we thought that this is an opportunity to put that ban in place as part of EPR legislation so that producers cannot use chemical recycling as a way to deal with the plastic that they produce. This is also part of a larger problem. Unfortunately, Canada's zero plastic plan includes incineration, which is unfortunate because incineration is not an actual recycling solution, as I said. So it's not actually zero waste. What we have to do is shift the focus from what we call downstream processes, so what we do to the plastic after it's all used up, and focus instead on upstream, so at the source, reducing plastic. Right, one of the most common analogies I've seen, and I think makes a lot of sense, is talking about turning off the tap. Right, it makes no sense to try to mop up, say, the bathroom floor if the tub is still on. You're never going to be able to actually clean up. And this is the same kind of thing. We're never actually going to be able to clean up all the plastic that we have produced and put in our environment if we keep producing it, and we're increasing the production at that. So our second ask, as a part of what we want to see in EPR, is that the province creates an environment and incentives for refillable and reusable containers instead of single use. We have a couple of single use bans right now, but we want to see a more holistic shift towards upstream solutions, reducing plastic at the source. And that, we think, is the only way that we're actually going to be able to tackle this problem. Plastic is also tied to fossil fuels. Right? Plastic is made from oil, made from fossil fuels. And so these two industries are incredibly closely tied together. We may be shifting away from gas vehicles, and maybe pushing more towards electric vehicles, which is not a solution, but that's a different problem. But what's happening is that instead of going towards cars and heating, plastic production is ramping up. There are billions and billions of dollars invested every year in creating more plastic. And that's compared to companies being like, oh look, we invested $5 million into this recycling program. Great, that sounds real nice. But if you look at the numbers of what we're investing in more production, it's nothing at all. And it's all about PR and greenwashing. We do something look green when it really isn't. And so what we need to do is send a signal to these producers, to these companies, and one way we can do that is through legislation. And part of what's nice about being last in the country, with this very big silver lining, is that we have seen what everyone else has done. Europe also has EPR legislation. We can learn from others' mistakes. We can try to make a stronger legislation so that we can protect our province and the environment more widely. So, the way that you can help is that we have created a letter, it's already written, however you can edit it if you'd like, on our website. The website is on your sheet. We're also going to distribute little tickets through that here with the QR code and the website there again. All you have to do if you'd like is to put in your name, click sign, and an email will be sent to the Books Material Stewardship Board, who is responsible right now for coordinating the consultation on legislation, so this is the time for us to have our voices heard and to tell them that we want to see EPR. This is a good thing, but we also want to see it done right, because we want to protect our environment, our health, our right to live well. So you can sign and distribute that. Thank you. If you want to do more, go ahead and reach out to your local want to see in legislation. You can make calls. You can be more active if you'd like. But the one thing that we ask you to do is to sign the letter, and that will show, send a signal that people care about this and that they want to see this done.
the sparrow has come to home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she places her young, near your counsel. You are attentive to all you have made. God who listens to every person living thing.
Help
us to sin in Holy God, help us provide refuge to every animal, plant, with whom we live. Help us be attentive to all you have made. God who our creation sees. Loving God, Jesus Christ, gave the Holy Spirit, the earth shook and the rocks split, thrilled by the whole creation that listens to you, God to whom all creation responds.
Help us respond to you.
Loving God, help us hear and know you, just as the earth and the rocks split. Help us learn from the way in which we seek creation, recognize your glorious beauty, God to whom all creation responds.
Help us respond to you.
Loving God, you are present. Creation and seek to heal her wounds. We found walking in the garden, opening our eyes to see the God who is present in creation.
Help us to be present too.
Loving God, the author of everything in creation, God is with us. Help us to follow and trust us in our own journey. Loving God, He is ever for us, knows each cry of justice, and is attentive to suffering of the earth. Do just to listen, bring healing into our lives, that we may protect the world and not pray on it. That we may listen to the word we have created and not close ourselves off from it. Reveal to us the ways in which we have failed to hear your voice, and how we treat the earth, God, who listens to everyone and live.
Thank you.
And now, as our Savior Christ's Thomas, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And may the peace of God that passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ. May the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. I'm going to do an advanced blessing on our food, which we're going to have afterwards. We will mark you and I'll bless all that food that God has given us this day. For food in the world where many walk in hunger, for faith in a world where many walk in fear, for friends in a world many walk alone, this too will we give thee thanks. Do we have any announcements for our congregation this week? Any birthdays or anniversaries? Yes, Mary.
It's okay if I say my name, Dale.
Oh, your aunt's birthday?
She's Dale from here.
Okay.
She's going to be 100 people.
Oh my goodness, 100 people. I wish Doris a happy birthday. Happy birthday, folks. A little birdie told me that Gracie had a birthday in a week. That's Roland and Marilyn's granddaughter. So wish Gracie a happy birthday, please. And if any of you have birthdays in your two, let's keep it secret. Well, happy birthday to you too. Happy anniversary. If you have anyone in your family who's celebrating this week, please let me know. Also, the day we remember.